Hi friends, welcome back to React.js 0 to Hero series. This series is for beginners who wants to learn React.js from scratch. In the last video, I have explained about components. In this video, I'm going to explain about props. Let's start. When I was explaining about components, I was telling components are mainly for reusability. Even in our last example, we have created a student component and reused that student component inside our app component. But you can see, all these are static contents, or otherwise, we can say hard-coded contents. It should be good if we pass these contents from the component where we are actually using the student component. In our case, it is going to be app component. We can do that in React using props. Props are arguments passed into React components through HTML attributes. Let me show you how we can use props. In this student component, we are showing the text name. Instead, we are going to pass the name from parent component and show it here. For that, I can go to the parent component and pass different names. It is kind of a key value pair and I need to use the same key for a particular prop. Here I am having the key as first name. Now in the student component, it receives the argument as a props object. Let me print this props object. Actually, we can use any name here, but usually we use props. Props means properties. So here we can see this object is having a property first name, which I can use here to show the value of first name. And so we can see the actual first names in each component. Let me quickly pass the age and country properties also here. And so we can see them also in the console. Now let me change the student component to use these properties. And so now we can see the component is showing dynamic content. Hope you understood the use of props. There are certain things we need to keep in mind when we use props. Props are case sensitive. Props are read-only. Props follow one-way data flow. Let me explain these in detail. First, props are case sensitive. That means we need to make sure we are accessing the props using the same name which we used in the parent component. For example, here for first name, I have used caps N. And we can see even in the props object, the key is having caps N. And so if I try to access the props using first name where N is not in caps, it will not work. Let me print that and show it to you. We can see it is undefined. Let me use the correct property name. Okay, it is fine now. Next, I have told props are read-only. That means we cannot change the props value. Let me try to change the value of first name in props. We can see we got the error. Cannot assign to read-only property first name of object. That means we cannot change the value. They are read-only. Finally, I have told props follow one-way data flow. That means we can pass data from only parent to child. Child cannot push props back to parent. Okay, let me explain one more thing before we close. Here we are getting the props and we are using each prop wherever needed like this. This is a small component. But assume in some other component, we are using the same prop in different places. So instead of using props.key in all the places, we can get it in a variable first and then use that variable wherever needed like this. And even instead of doing like this, we can use one of the ES6 features, object destructuring. Using that, we can directly destructure the values of these variables from the props object. And finally, instead of using a separate variable for props object, we can directly use that as argument. This will also work. Hope you understood. Okay, you can try this task. Create an application like this, in which you can create a button component which accepts some props. You can use this component inside your app component and pass the respective props and try to create a variety of buttons like this. In case you need the solution code, you can get it from this GitHub repo. The link is available in the description. That's all for today. Please like this video, subscribe my channel and support me. Thank you. Bye.